Hi guys, welcome back. If it's the first time you're seeing these videos, my name is Morten and I'm from Denver Electronics. I'm the product marketing manager here. I'm going to tell you a little about some of our products. Today I'm focusing on our wildlife cameras, especially the ones with MMS function, where you can put in a SIM card and make it send your pictures while it's out in the forest or where you use it. There are some things that you need to pay attention to when using a wildlife camera. First of all, the specifications of the camera has some specs that can be misunderstood. For example, the shutter speed on a camera like this is set to approximately half a second or so, 0.3 seconds. This is the time from the motion sensor in the camera detects something and until the shutter actually works. It doesn't mean that you can take a picture on 0.3 seconds. It only means that it starts working after 0.3 seconds. Depending on your SD card that you put inside the camera, the actual footage takes maybe 1.5 seconds, maybe 2 seconds, depending on light conditions and how much movement there is and so on. This means that if you have the camera put up on a tree or a pole of some sort and an animal runs right past the camera, this won't take 1 or 2 seconds to get on the other side of the camera. So this can mean that you get some pictures without any animals on. Therefore, it's always a good thing when you put the camera up, pretend that you're the camera, make sure that it looks in a wide area so that you can have surveillance on the largest possible area. Of course, within the range that it supports. Another thing to think of is when using this camera at night, it has all these infrared lights right here. These are what you call black IR LEDs, so they aren't very visible for human eyes. You can just see them a little bit. Very, very little red light will appear. This lights up pretty effective, and if you inside the settings set it to long distance, then it will turn up these IR lights to absolute maximum. So if you're recording something close to the camera, you can risk that it will be simply overlit, that it will just be all white. So if you have it put up somewhere within maybe 5 meters is where you are interested in having the footage, then make sure to set it in low. If it's a little bit longer, medium, and if it's all the way out to 10 plus meters at night, then set it to long distance. There are some delay that you can put inside the camera as well in the menu. This means that after it has taken a photo or a video, it will take several X seconds before the motion detector turns on again. So if you set it on, for example, 10 seconds, then it registers some motion, takes a photo or video depending on your settings, and then it takes 10 seconds before it activates again. So this can mean that you don't get quite the amount of pictures as if you set it on, let's say, 1 second. When it takes a picture, it first takes the picture, saves it on the SD card, and then sends it if you have set it to that using your SIM card. One very important thing to know when you are getting your camera and your SIM card is the SIM card needs following things. It needs to support 2G GSM because this is what the module inside can send with. So if you have a telecompany that only has 3G and 4G, then you can't use this SIM card. Luckily, most telecompanies support 2G GSM still, but this is important to notice. Also, there can be no SIM card lock on the SIM card, no PIN code. So if you have this, put it inside a phone first, remove the PIN code, and then you can use it inside the camera. Also, it's a very good idea to have some sort of free MMS or something like that, because it uses MMS to send the pictures with. So if it's a prepaid card where you pay for each MMS, this can go pretty fast that you don't have any more money on the prepaid card. So good idea to choose a SIM card with free MMS. Yes. Okay, I'll turn to the PC right now and show you how to set up this. I will use an example because you need different things from your telecompany, but I'll show you an example on how to do it. See you. Okay, now we've started our MMS config program, and we have three different fields that you can fill out or do some adjustments inside. First of all, the menu right here shown at the top. You can set the resolution of the camera. I like to set it at the highest possible. The interval is this delay function. If you set it to 1 second, then after it has taken a photo, it will just have 1 second pause before it turns on the motion detector again. This one, multi, is how many pictures it shall take. If it's just a single picture, three pictures, six pictures, and so on. The ISO definition right here can be set to three different settings: 100, 200, and 400, and on some cameras also to an auto setting. If you experience that your pictures are getting too light, then try setting this ISO up to maybe 400. Then it's not so light sensitive as it is if set to 100. Okay, the resolution here is the video resolution. Video length, 10, 30, 60, or 90 seconds. And if you need sound on the video as well, you can adjust here. Right here in the right side is mode, camera, video, or both, camera and video. It's important to notice that it will only send you pictures. It cannot send you video through MMS. It's simply too large. But if it's set to both, then it will send you a picture and it will save both the picture and the video onto the SD card. Okay, I'll just leave it on camera. Language, the distance is, as I spoke about earlier, depends a bit on how far the area that you want to record is. If set to high, then the infrared light is at absolute maximum. So it's a good thing just to play a little around with this to find the best possible setting. I'll normally set it to medium or normal as shown here. This TV mode is just for the screen on the camera itself. It doesn't matter what it's in NTSC or PAL. It doesn't matter. Date and time can be adjusted manually, but usually just follows the computer, so it's not necessary to do. And a password, you can set it on or off if you want to protect the recordings a bit more on the camera itself. You can set a timer as well if you only want the camera to be active between, let's say, 8 and midnight at night. You can set it right here. Okay, one important thing is the MMS part right here. To do a correct setting here, you need to set MMS to on. Some countries has a little settings. For example, for Denmark, we have two different companies that you can pre-choose here, but otherwise you need following things from your telecom money. Set MMS mode to manual, country and operator just to other, and pictures per day you can actually adjust. If you only want 10 pictures per day, then it will just stop after these 10 pictures, but I usually just leave it on 99. Okay, these things has to be absolute correct to work. So you need following things from your telecom money. APN, an account password, is usually just left blank, but you need to ask your telecom money about this as well. MMSC you need, IP, or the telecom money can also call this proxy, and then the port. These four things, or six things if you have account and password as well, has to be absolute correct in order to work. Otherwise, it won't send you anything. Okay, I just found something on the SIM card I use right here in Denmark. It's called Telmo. On their website, I can find manual setup for MMS. This is in Danish. I'm sorry about that, but I think you can see the things anyway. So APN is called MMS. So I simply into this right here and say APN is called MMS. There are no username and no password, it says. MMSC is this long string right here. It's actually not very easy to copy, so sometimes you have to put it in manually. But I think I can copy it right here. Let's see. So I go down to MMSC, insert this. This is the same that I've shown on the website. And the IP, or the proxy as it's called as well, MMS proxy is the same as IP address. It's this inetproxy.tdc.dk. And Telmo, or TDC in Denmark, is a bit special because they actually have two proxies. So if this one doesn't work, then you can use these numbers instead. So again, you need to ask your telecom company because it's different from each company. The port is called 8080. It's a normal thing, but again, you need to ask. Then you insert a telephone number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's just an example, of course. If you don't have the camera in the same country, you need to enter the country code as well. So in this case, 0045 if the camera was outside of Denmark, but it isn't. So just the 8 cipher number. And an email if you want email as well. test@test.dk. So just an example again. The SMTP part can 99% of the times be left off. You only need to use this if you want the emails that you receive to look like they come from a certain email server. So if you don't have these needs, just use the MMS part. If you have these needs, you need to ask for the SMTP settings at your telecom company as well. You need to enter this on the APN, and you need to have a sender email right here. It can be Gmail, Hotmail, something else. But I suggest you just use the MMS field right here. It's the easiest thing to do. Okay, now we have it filled out and we need to save it. This is again a very important thing. You need to save it on the root of the SD card. So I push save. I have inserted my SD card. And it's shown right here as a G drive. It says DVD drive, but it is my USB stick. I need to save it directly here. I can't put it inside any folder. Sometimes there is a folder called DCIM. You can't put it inside there. It has to be directly on the G drive. And the file name as well, you can't change it at all. It has to be named parameter.dat. On some PCs, you can't see the part after the dot. Doesn't matter. Just don't rename the file at all. So I save it, and that's actually it. Then we have done our settings right here. Okay, I think and hope that makes it a bit easier to set up your Denver wildlife camera. When you have the SD card, you re-insert it into the camera. Just make sure it's pushed all the way in. And then you turn the power button to test, just to check if everything is looking correct on the display. After this, you can turn it to on, right here. And then you can leave the camera, and it actually should start sending your pictures. First time it can take a minute or two because it needs to have access to the telecompany's settings and so on. But then after this, it should work just fine. It doesn't matter if it's day or night. The camera will automatically turn on the IR light whenever it's needed. So I hope this helps. As always, please let us know if there is anything we can help you with. If there are some products that you want us to make a video about or anything else. See you next time. Bye.